Okay, guys, welcome back to the Congo River for the Nile perch. Now, over the last probably 2 or 3 days, I've caught anywhere between 70 to like 120 of these unique Nile perch. Yes, uniques. That's, yeah, I was up here quite a bit. And I've learned quite a bit, and we're going to be going through this, what I learned in the video. But anyway, guys, we are going to go in here. Show you the there is a almost a seventh spot, but it overlaps with the other one, and we're going to show you the spots. But I want you to keep in mind, I only use generally the last two spots or last three spots. So first off, we have over here, as you can see here, this is 21 by negative 8 90, and if you want, you can go ahead and mark these and pause them for the marks. Now, the last couple spots I'll be going over, but this one is actually far enough away where it's kind of like 6.5 spots or 7 spots, but this one's still close. Obviously, if you catch it here, you're not going to catch it here, but same with this one here. This is another perch spot at the waterfall, and that is the boat marker. So if you want to add them to your map, it's negative 180, negative 886. And I'm going to show you guys the setups and the jig head versus the, we'll have the discussion about jig head versus rigs later on too. So stick around. I'm just showing you all the unique spots. There is another one here. Like I said, there is 7 unique spots now that I know of. I'm sure there's more out there, but like I said in the last video, it is pretty pointless to have more than what is already out there. And then also right here, and you can pause them for the coordinates if you just want to add them onto your map. And all of them are, you do not have to be exactly on the mark. You can cast anywhere around that mark area and get one. And then I'm going to show you the marks now, guys. And then we'll go up to these spots here. So everybody kind of knows about the waterfall spot. And that's where most of these are, you know, I just showed the 7 of them. A lot of people fish down here. Now, I'm going to show you a problem with this one, guys. Is you have down here, we're going to get down here, it's going to be a little loud. You have this invisible barrier down here that fights you. Now, this is a good spot, but you waste a lot of time catching fish. But if you see, there is actually an invisible barrier down here that, see, I can't go past that. And there is the one spot over there that's kind of a new spot that I found. Somebody sent me the marks for it. Thanks, Zebra, for that. And then over here, guys, is kind of the number 2 spot that I use. You know, the waterfall. But like I said, this invisible barrier, fighting it is kind of a waste of time. And so I will use it. Oop, let's go over here. And let's go up to the best spot here. And this is not my spot. This is a spot Ian has found. And then we kind of worked on it together after that. But we're going to talk about a few things here really quick. Now, everybody's asking, how did you get the big ones? It's just luck, guys. I've seen a 4-0 jig head with a 4-inch shad actually catch a 440-pound one. Now, obviously, the bigger the hook you use, the more likely that you'll get the bigger one, but I'm just saying you can actually catch it on all of them, guys. Now, so this is my favorite spot here. The barrier is way back there, and it's kind of hard to get, and you can catch them this way, right here. Now, we're going to talk about what I use. So, you can either use a jig head, a barbless. There's 2 ways to go about doing it, and there's 2 different reasons to do this, guys. You can use a jig head, a barbless jig head. This is one of the, I like both ways equally, they have differences. So if you're looking for XP and a higher bite rate, this 8-0 on the barbless shad, or on this, with the barbless jig head, It's going to get you more XP than the rig will. It's just, the fact is it is. Also, if you could use this rib, any of the 6-inch shads work, but the pink or the glow-in-the-dark worked really well. And the glow-in-the-dark does work during the day. Also, just keep in mind, too, you're going to get a quicker bite rate on here with the jig head, but it will actually fight you a little harder on this jig head. You will get more experience. And like I say, they do bite a little quicker on the jig head. Now, I'm going to show you guys the other way to catch them as well that is quick. So we're going to go ahead and throw on, where is, oh, we got to unequip that. There we go. And I could not get these Texas or Carolina rigs to work as well, or the three-way. But the Texas rig with, let's go down here. Oh, but I have to actually put it on. So if you guys don't know how the Texas rig actually works here, it kind of, when you're setting it up kind of like a leader to most point, and you're putting a weight on it. You want to balance the size of the rig that you're using to what weight your pole or line is. So, for example, it's 97, or my pole is 95, 97, 97, so I put on 97. And you want to use these offset hooks. I do have a video on how to use these rigs, but eventually you need your rig, your weight. And as you can see here, it is a bullet sinker for Texas. And then your offset hook here. And I use a 10-0 for bite rates. Now, you can go bigger. As you see, I did go practice with it bigger. The hook size that you use isn't going to make you just catch a big fish. Now, it can help you a little bit on the way, but as long as you're using bigger than a 6-0, you can catch a unique or a 4-0. I've seen, like I said, that big 4-0 caught. And on this setup, you just use the same things. You can either use this shad or this perch or this piece right here. Just keep in mind when you're catching these, the bite rate will be a tiny bit slower. And because this is an offset hook and not a barbless hook, like the jig head, you're going to get a little bit less XP. The one bonus, though, about rigs, guys, is they generally don't fight quite as hard on the than they do on the jig head. The jig head, once in a great while, you can lose one, whereas on the rig, it's harder to lose it. But just keep in mind, you're also not going to get as much XP. And on the rig, the bite rate is slightly slower. It isn't like a big difference. It's probably not even worth mentioning other than the fact that I was here so long and tested both of them out. But like I said, both of them work great. I've caught both big fish on both of them. For example, my biggest has come off of a offset or a Texas rig, but on a 8-0 jig, I actually have one almost exactly the same weight as my biggest one. So both of them can catch you big fish. It's just whether you need XP or not, or you're casually fishing. If you need to level up, I would be using the jig head. And if you don't need to level up, honestly, the rig works just fine. So that's up to you guys. But anyway, definitely recommend using this spot up here. I'll show this to you on the map. This is my favorite spot out of all of them. And guys, you can actually catch in each spot. You can catch a trophy and a unique, but if you catch them too close to each other, for example, if you catch a unique down here at the waterfall, you're not going to catch one over here, guys. It's only three possible, so if you catch one here, you need to catch one here in the middle, and then up here at the top on the same peak. Like I said, each spot has a trophy and a unique to go along with it. And you can catch the unique and still get the trophy. They're not overlapping on that front. And like I said, you can catch three. I've definitely caught multiples of two, and I have one time caught three. But like I said, they can change that, but you can catch three on one little peak. You just have to move down. How I caught mine was I caught one here, I caught one here, and then I caught one down here. So just keep that in mind. There's a lot, and this can change too. But this is why I'm doing the updated video, is because there's been a lot of questions on how many can you catch in one peak. And it's that, and it seems like at first glance the respawn timers are 5 hours. I haven't caught them quicker than 5 hours in game, and so an hour and 15 minutes real time before they respawn, just so you guys know. But a lot of that you want to worry about because fill your bag so quick. Okay, so when I'm fishing for these guys, I make sure my boat is unanchored. As you can see in the bottom right corner, it is unanchored so that they can pull me around. Some people say these fish are fighting them very hard. If you don't have your boat anchored, you're not going to have too much issue. Also, as long as you're not using that barrier at the waterfall, that's why I don't use the waterfall as much, because to me it's not as good of a spot, because you have to fight that barrier. Over here, you don't need to fight that, and you can just drag them in. And when I cast out, I let it sink almost all the way to the bottom, and then I keep it right above the bottom doing stop and go, and it seems to work out just fine for me. And like I said, I have caught a ton of these uniques to level up from, to level up to 80. As you can see, I went from 72 to 80 in about a day and a half. But anyway, guys, hopefully this helps you out. We'll see you next time, folks. Have a good one.
It's like every few written.
Damn, fuck off.
Nice. Damn,
you
Dave.
Fucking piece of no good shit.